confidence of champions. These Detroit Pistons have moved to within one game of their first ever NBA World title. Through three games of the NBA Finals, the Pistons' backcourt has scorched the Los Angeles Lakers in every conceivable fashion. Now the improbable is possible. The Pistons can sweep away the Lakers. With Magic Johnson relegated to the role of cheerleader, the defending champions again will rely on past heroes. No team plays with greater pride than the Los Angeles Lakers. And tonight, they will need every resource, or an era will come crashing to an end. Chuck Daly's Motown sound is just one win away from NBA gold. Tonight, Detroit tries to become the newly crowned world champion. Well, for years, people have flocked to the Los Angeles area seeking health and happiness. Tonight, the Detroit Pistons will come to the Forum in Inglewood, California, hoping to take away what has belonged to the Los Angeles Lakers for 2 years, and that is the NBA championship. Laker fans here in Los Angeles have not given up. The beautiful people arriving in their limousines. It's around 6 o'clock Pacific time, and again, we'll have another packed Forum crowd hoping to boost their heroes to their first victory in this NBA final. So come on inside the Forum with us. Pull up a chair, sit back and enjoy the 1989 NBA Finals on CBS. It's Game 4, the Detroit Pistons and the Los Angeles Lakers. Good evening, everybody, and welcome. I'm Brent Musburger. Well, tonight, the Detroit Pistons can wrap up the Larry O'Brien Trophy, and as you know, this area was hit with a couple of earthquakes yesterday afternoon, but that would pale by comparison if the beloved Lakers went down in four straight. And to the Pistons of all teams, take a look at the sports franchises throughout the years that have last won championships. I mean, for the Cubs in baseball, you go back to 1908, to the Rangers in hockey, 1940. To the now Phoenix Cardinals in the NFL, it was 1947. And as for the Pistons, well, never. In fact, 40 years ago, they weren't even in Detroit. They were in Fort Wayne, Indiana. They were owned by a man named Freddie Zollner. And they started out as the Fort Wayne Zollners. Had a great scorer back then. George Yardley was his name. And they've had some great players through the years. Gene Shue was there, Dave Bing, Bob Lanier. And now tonight, this group of Pistons can win their first ever NBA championship, led by their wondrous backcourt. Isaiah Thomas, he's the ringleader. But how about the shooting that Vinny Johnson has done in this series? And then the all-around play of Joe Dumars. If you were to vote for the MVP right now, certainly Dumars would be the leading candidate. The Lakers, they have to win to stay alive, but there is another great story involving the Lakers. This could be the last time that this great player ever walks down the tunnel to put on a basketball uniform to go to work. For 20 years in the NBA, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, 6 NBA titles, 3 NCAA championships at UCLA. A short time ago, he spoke with Pat O'Brien.
Kareem, whether this be a 7th game or a 4th game, I'm sure you were faced with this thought of being your final game and your thoughts tonight.
I haven't really been focusing on that, Pat. I've just been trying to deal with what we have to do to try and win a game. And that has consumed all my time and energy and my thoughts, and I'll give over to the other things at the appropriate time.
What do you have to do, and how confident are you about tonight?
Well, I think we can, I know we can beat them. It's just that a lot of things have gone against us. We just have to give our best effort and hope something good happens.
Good luck tonight, Kareem.
Thank you.
Back to you, Brent.
And here is Kareem, who played a spectacular game on Sunday in Game 3, and his parents are here from New York. Al and Cora Alcindor have come to watch their legendary son tonight and what will could wind up being his last basketball game ever. Now, Magic Johnson and Byron Scott will not play in this game. Magic said he intended to wear his sweatsuit because he would sweat through his regular clothes, but he said, I'm not even going to have a uniform on. There's no need for me even to try tonight. And Byron Scott unable to go. So the Lakers indeed are hamstrung. We're going to come back and talk more about Game 4 as the Detroit Pistons go for a sweep of the NBA Finals, coming your way in just a moment. At a war without a victor. That will not be the case here tonight. Let's go down to the floor now. Dick Stockton and Hubie Brown. Dick.
All right, Brent, what this series is all about is Piston greatness and not Laker injuries. And to the Lakers' credit, they have not used that as an excuse because I think they know what kind of a buzzsaw they are up against. And in fact, we all should marvel whether the series ends tonight or not at arguably the best defense we have ever seen in the National Basketball Association, the Detroit Pistons. That's how tough they have been. Meanwhile, on the other side of the ball, on attack, there is no question their prolific scoring of the three guards has been the story, as Hubie Brown brings us up to date.
The play of Detroit's top three guards has been nothing short of sensational in this series. Through three games, they have accounted for over 60% of the team's offense. And with a dazzling display of footwork, shooting, head fakes, and the ability to challenge and to take the ball into the heart of the defense, they have terrorized the Los Angeles Lakers through the first three games and are on a pace to become the most dominant trio of guards ever to play in the NBA Finals. Their presence remains the challenge to the Lakers' defense tonight.
And it's really surprising that the Lakers, despite adjustments, have not been able to stop these guards in any of the three games. Normally, you find a way of stopping him, and they haven't for the three games. But, Hubie, let me ask you about the motivation for the Lakers down 3-0.
Well, any time that you think that you could possibly be swept, you join a very small list of people. This team is the team of the 80s. They have a ball club with incredible pride. I expect them to come out tonight, be very physical, take away the lane, and invoke the rule, no layups.
Hubie, the Lakers have come close in two out of the three games, but what must they do to win tonight's game?
Well, I think James Worthy must come out of his slump. He's struggling from the field and on the foul line. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and Michael Thompson prove that if they will go to them offensively, that they can create the offense as well as getting the opposition in foul problems. But we must look at the peripheral people and say, who else is going to step forward and score the necessary points?
Well, despite the cushion, Bill Laimbeer told the teammates today, let's not take any chances. Don't let them off the floor. Let's supply the crusher. We'll see what happens, Brent.
Dick, you know, ironically, the last team to be swept in a final, the same Lakers right here in the Forum back in 83 by the Philadelphia 76ers. But this year, the Lakers could become the first team in the history of the league ever to sweep their way into the finals and then be swept out in four straight games. As for the Detroit Pistons, if they win it, they will become the first team of this decade other than Los Angeles, Boston, or Philadelphia to win an NBA final. When we come back now, you're going to meet the starting lineups as we get ready for Game 4 of the NBA Finals in just a moment.
This is what great ice-cold draft beer used to look like. This is what it looks like today. Cold.
Out is in place here at the Forum in Inglewood, California. There is Magic Johnson out of uniform in sweat clothes. And Byron Scott has been in civilian clothes throughout this series. And for the introduction of the starting lineups, the public address announcer, Lawrence Tanner.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Great Western Forum for Game 4 of the NBA Finals between the Eastern Conference champions, the Detroit Pistons, and the defending world champions, your Los Angeles Lakers. First, the starting lineup of the visiting Detroit Pistons. At forward, number 23 from DePaul, Mark Aguirre. The other forward is number 44 from Hampton Institute, Rick Mahorn. At center, number 40 from Notre Dame, Bill Laimbeer. At guard, number 4 from McNeese State, Joe Dumars. And at guard, number 11 from Indiana, Isaiah Thomas. Head coach for the Pistons, Chuck Daly. And now, the starting lineup of the defending world champions, your Los Angeles Lakers. At guard, number 19 from Ohio State, Tony Campbell. At guard, number 21 from New Mexico, Michael Cooper. At forward, number 45 from Oregon State, A.C. Green. At forward, number 42 from North Carolina, James Worthy. And at center, number 33 from UCLA, the captain, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Head coach for the Lakers, Pat Riley.
Pat Riley is still seeking his 99th playoff win, which would tie him with Arnold Red Auerbach. Chuck Daly looking for his first title. This is the way the series has gone. First two games were played at the Palace. Detroit won by 12, but the last two games have been awfully close, UB Brown. And in fact, the Lakers have had the lead going into the fourth quarter in the last two contests.
But the Detroit defense has been able to choke them off, Dick, and their inability to get their offense going in the last 6 minutes has caused defeat.
Earl Strom, Jack Madden, and Jess Kersey are the officials working tonight's game number 4. Lakers the first team to score over 100 points against Detroit in the playoffs. They have in the last two games scoring 105 and then 110, but both in losing causes. Well, there's Kareem, who turned back the clock in dramatic fashion. And Isaiah Thomas looking for the title. Abdul-Jabbar with 13 rebounds to go along with the 24 points that Brent talked about at the top. Set to go. Do the Pistons wrap it up, or do the Lakers hang in there? It'll be Laimbeer in blue jumping against Kareem in gold. And it's controlled by the Lakers. Tony Campbell goes right up and travels before the layup. Tony Campbell, who has averaged in double figures and is forced to start in Magic Johnson's position, has played well for the Lakers after not playing much all season. Now the Pistons, Hubie.
The Pistons right now are looking for their motion offense. What they try to do is spread the floor.
Mahorn in the lane. Laimbeer and Green, and it's Green.
The Lakers must try to get the easy baskets in this first half. Go to Kareem Abdul-Jabbar or Worthy early to see if Detroit will double-team the post people.
They go to Kareem, and he's fouled. The Lakers would love to do that all night, but Detroit ready to double if necessary on the 42-year-old great.
I think that if you're Chuck Daly in tonight's ballgame, you know, you're pleading to your players to keep the intensity, to understand that you want to knock out the opponent tonight. You do not want to give them any life so that they have some confidence in this next ball game, which would be played in this building.
He attended the fight last night between Hearns and Leonard, and he said the one thing I saw was the intense concentration. I told the team, just concentrate for 48 more minutes. You don't have to worry about any more games after that. Cooper is guarding Isaiah Thomas. And that ties the score. Cooper played all 48 minutes of game number 3 on Sunday. Campbell hits the deck, and we have a foul away from the ball.
You'll see Isaiah here coming around. Now watch the excellent defense by Cooper, and Isaiah still puts that ball in.
Laimbeer picked up the first foul on Kareem Mahorn this last time. James Worthy misses from the corner, and Laimbeer can't save it.
See, the reason why this is significant about James Worthy getting off to a high percentage shooting night. He leads the team in shot attempts. They know that he's going to get his shots, and if he could just explode, it would be inspirational to the rest of the players.
He has averaged 3 points in this series below his playoff average. He's the big gun without Scott and Magic Johnson in the lineup. Double team on Kareem with Laimbeer and Aguirre, now triple. And they foul him.
See, I like Kareem's spirit early tonight, Dick. He is challenging that double and triple team. He's saying to himself, I'm going to get to the foul line.
The foul is on Mark Aguirre. He picks up two quick ones and goes out of the game, replaced by Dennis Rodman. Aguirre visibly upset, but Rodman has been a dynamo off the boards for Detroit. James Worthy working inside, lays it in.
Anytime that they take Worthy one-on-one versus Mahorn. Oh, yes.
Mahorn knocked Cooper down. And they're going to call him for it.
Watch out. Watch out.
If punches are thrown, it's automatic ejection. Just remember that.
Now, coming down the floor that time, Dick, Cooper stepped right in front of Mahorn and was not going to let him get to an offensive position.
These are the same two guys who mixed it up on Sunday. And you remember that the Lakers can least afford losing any player. The foul is definitely against Rick Mahorn. John Sally is going to come in for Detroit, replacing Mahorn.
Well, you can see Mahorn is really upset. You'll see on the left side of the screen, he knocked Cooper to the ground. Now A.C. Green has his hands on him, but words are spoken right here between Cooper and Mahorn. As we can say, if Cooper should go out of this game for any reason, injury, foul problem, or what, the Lakers are in deep trouble at that point guard position.
Double technical called against Cooper and Mahorn. Mahorn's out of the game, replaced by John Sally. So a quick team in there for the Pistons. Campbell will get the roll, and the Lakers lead 6-2 early on. Less than 2 minutes gone by. So the starting forwards, Aguirre and Mahorn, are on the bench for Detroit. That's not a big surprise. Dumars working against Campbell.
I like Campbell's defense. He's moving his feet really well.
And he walks. Turns it over to the Lakers.
See, Tony Campbell is definitely a main link here. We're not only talking from the offensive standpoint because he's looking for his shot, but the key is to put some solid defense on Joe Dumars.
Michael Cooper, by the way, may be the toughest of all of the Lakers. He can be a scrappy guy. Dumars denying Campbell. No double team right now on Kareem. Missed a sky hook, but Campbell is there, and he's fouled inside. And that'll be the fourth team foul against Detroit already.
He just is uptight with his ball club because the Lakers are coming up with the offensive foul on the offensive rebound. But Tony Campbell is a live body here tonight.
The foul is on Sally. The team fouls all for Detroit thus far. And here is Campbell, who has averaged nearly 13 points a game in this series. You remember, he was drafted by the Pistons and played 3 years and very rarely got off the bench for it.
I think of the pressure on this young man, and he's answered by scoring double figures and shooting over 60% so far.
So he's come through in a big way. 9:25 remaining. Laimbeer crashes Green, and they'll call A.C. Green with the foul, and Bill Laimbeer will shoot a pair. Laimbeer has not scored that much or played all that much in this series, giving way to James Edwards.
See, something to look forward to in this ball game. If you watch the Lakers defensively, anytime the ball is on the side of the floor, they will double team and they will allow Detroit to roll a guy to the basket. Now this time they found Laimbeer, and it's going to hurt him with two shot opportunities here.
Just the first Laker foul of the game. The Lakers are 6-1 at home here at the Forum in the playoffs. But maybe more telling is the fact that the Pistons have a road record of 6-1. in postseason.
They've been absolutely outstanding, backing up their road winning record during the season of 26-15, way out in front of any other ball club in the NBA.
Pistons trapping three quarters.
This is interesting. It's the first time in the series that we're seeing it.
And on the shot clock, they double on Kareem, and Green gets the pass and the layup. He found his man, as he has done so many times in his 20-year career.
Who has ever played the game at the center position? Who could you say is a better passer than Kareem?
Bill Laimbeer hits a three-point basket. That's only the fourth three-point shot for the Pistons in this series to bring them to within three. Now Worthy in the low post gets the double-team treatment. Campbell lost the ball. He's in trouble. Kareem said, look what I have here. Let's see who touched it last. Pistons, it's still Laker ball. And they have 6 seconds to attempt a shot with 8:34 to go in the first quarter.
Well, Pat Riley's calling for a quick-hitting type of a play now. They only have 6 seconds.
Green, Rodman gambled. Green goes up with a shot. And A.C. Green just with a second basket. A two-point shot.
Just like they have in the book. Come on now.
I didn't see the book. Sally posting up against Green. And John Sally, if there's one thing he's shown in this series, is that his offense has moved up a notch.
Oh, he's looking for the shot.
Shooting has been solid on both sides. Turnaround by Campbell. Rodman, and they'll call a loose ball foul against the Pistons, and it'll be against Dennis Rodman. And now the Pistons are in the penalty with 8 minutes to go in the quarter.
This is a tremendous advantage for the Lakers right now. When you consider there are still 8 minutes to go in this quarter, and you are already in the penalty.
A.C. Green on the line. He has led the Lakers in rebounding in two out of the three games, but basically has cooled off in the last two series against the Suns and here again against Detroit.
You cannot underline the fact they are alive, and they are attacking the offensive board.
Lakers had a miserable time from the free throw line in game one. There's Dennis Rodman. And out of sight, off the boards, and is a defensive star for the Detroit Pistons all season. Green makes one, and it's a four-point Laker lead.
Isaiah has been very quiet up to date, Dick.
That won't last, and so is Dumars for that. Dumars gets fouled and nearly gets the basket as well. Keep in mind that these three guards have raised their point total in each game. Foul is on Campbell, his first, and Joe Dumars with a fantastic series. He has scored 20 or more points against the Lakers in five games, including regular season this year.
And remember, he always picks up the scoring offensive guard, which tires you. He's shooting over 60% and over 95 on the line. Well, there it goes again. Come on.
He should have given his free throw stats first. Doesn't it always happen? There's Vinny Johnson, the microwave, who has been sizzling in his own right. One out of two for Dumas. Just under 8 minutes to go in the first quarter. Dick Stockton and Hubie Brown again with the three-quarter trap by Detroit.
See, I like this. What they're doing is forcing the run time and to get the Lakers out of a set offense.
Nine on the shot clock. Worthy has Rodman on him. 2 seconds on the clock, and then James Worthy hits the field goal. So Green and Worthy, the starting forwards, have 9 of the Lakers' 15. Isaiah Thomas with his first shot of the game and has 4 points now.
They're absolutely fearless. They take it right down your throat and lay it up in your face.
Worthy looking for help now. Rodman and Sally doubling. Worthy spins his way in. Great move by James Worthy.
He gave us three moves in one, Dick.
Lead pass, Rodman. Blocked by Kareem. Rodman again. Worthy outlet to Campbell. Pistons back defensively, but Kareem with a big block on the defensive end. He wants the ball too. And Laimbeer trying to deny him inside. Here's Worthy again. Another basket by Worthy.
James Worthy is so hot right now off the dribble. You almost must have to take a step back off him and force him to take the jump shot.
Campbell already has one foul. Forces Dumars to turn it over to Cooper. Two on one. Campbell. And it's 21-12. A 9-point lead, and Chuck Daly wants a 20. Say they want to do is win one game, and they've come out strong with plays like this, Yubi.
Watch how strong he's going. There's your up move. Here comes right back, and with the left hand, he's giving it to you all tonight.
Worthy has 8, Green has 5, Campbell 6. They've done the
Welcome back to the Forum in Inglewood, California. We're a little early confidence here as the Lakers have gone up 21-12. Hope you're enjoying game 4 of the NBA Finals. You think about across America, people in their living rooms watching it, maybe having a couple of beers, a couple of friends over. We think we found the biggest television party in America, though. Let me show you this. Inside the palace at Auburn Hills, 20,000 people, 21,000 people, standing room only, paid $3 each to watch television, to cheer their Pistons on. And hi, everybody there in the palace. We can hear you from here. And Dick and Hubie, can you imagine? One television, who has got the remote control button? Let's go back to you guys.
Well, you know they're not going to change the channel, Pat. We're at the Forum at Inglewood, California, where the Lakers have come out to a 21-12 lead with just under 6 minutes to go in the first half. Magic Johnson can only cheer. The Pistons have won 6 in a row since they trailed the Bulls 2-1 in the Eastern Finals. And the Lakers have lost 3 straight after a 16-game winning streak, trying to reverse it all tonight. What's going on with the Pistons?
Well, I really like the way that Tony Campbell is setting a fine example of playing Joe Dumars off the dribble. They're almost cutting off the lane.
Dumars pass inside and nicely executed offense. LA has scored on 12 consecutive possessions. They're up by 7. Worthy, quick jumper. 10 points for James.
He's on a roll right now. Anytime that you can shoot over Sally, Sally even got a piece of that one.
Cooper and Thomas up top. Dumars. They want to get those guards going, and Joe Dumars with his first field goal of the game.
Give Bill Laimbeer credit. He's freed him up with 2 excellent picks.
Worthy has hit 6 in a row now. To add a gray hair to Chuck Daly's head, 25-16 L.A. Here's Dumars with a step on Campbell and is fouled and will shoot. That's the 13th foul against the Lakers.
Watch as Dumars comes off this pick. You'll see the catch. Tony Campbell gets bumped. Now watch this pass. He read Kareem on the double team right to Sally, and that's what you do. You slam it home.
Meanwhile, Tony Campbell has picked up his 2nd personal foul. As you know, the Lakers are thin anyway at guard, and that should enhance David Rivers' first appearance of this game as Dumars hits the first.
See, I like Chuck Daly's strategy. There's David Rivers waiting in, for his shot here to get an opportunity. Chuck Daly, he saw that Dumars was having trouble off the dribble with Tony Campbell. Now he's going to picks for Joe to free him up. That's heads up offensive coaching.
But Dumars misses his 2nd free throw. And the lead is 8. As far as the forwards go, it's been no contest. The Lakers lead. But Detroit's been getting points from their backcourt. They're already in the penalty. Scott gets away from Isaiah Thomas, and he gets his first 2. Biggest lead of this first quarter for L.A. is 10 points. Trail 3-0. Dumars trying to draw the foul does, and if it's Campbell, it'll be 3. Let's see, though. And it is 3 fouls on Tony Campbell, and he'll have to come out, and here is the rookie, David Rivers, from Notre Dame coming in. That's a tough break for the Lakers because Campbell, not only defensively, but he has been a scoring force for an unmanned team.
What will happen now is David Rivers will play Isaiah Thomas, and Cooper will move over and play Dumars. Now, this is this will be an interesting matchup, because then what we also have then is, let's see if Detroit will play David Rivers. The other night when he came into the ballgame, they laid off him and forced him to hit the outside shot.
You remember, he took that last shot of the game, a three-point attempt that Dumars blocked and kept in play to preserve the victory for the Pistons. 27-19. Rivers guarded by Thomas.
The Isaiah will really get up in there and force him to beat him off the dribble.
There's Rivers open at the foul line. And Rodman clears it. Dumars pushing it up now. Lambeer free, pops one from the corner. Rivers and Dumars collided. And here come the Lakers with a two-on-one break. It's Worthy. That's seven in a row for James Worthy.
See, the Detroit bench wanted an offensive foul on Cooper when he ran into Rodman, but in this league, you do not get that call. That is in high school and college.
Seven straight field goals and 14 points for James Worthy. Rivers is all over Isaiah Thomas. Green tipped it out of bounds, and 6 seconds for the Pistons to try a shot. L.A. off to the rebounding edge on Detroit.
Detroit, one of the top passing teams that we have in this league. Anytime you see a double team, they move the ball beautifully.
Here's Vinny Johnson, who scored 13 points in the fourth quarter, replacing Isaiah Thomas, who goes out having scored four. Dumars, way off. And a 24-second violation will turn it over to L.A. The Pistons are complaining about that. They had 6 seconds to attempt the shot, but it'll be Lakers ball. Now, the ball did not seem to touch the rim, but the three officials conferring now at midcourt.
Well, I think the argument is here is that the ball hit the backboard, but did the ball hit the backboard area or part of the rim before the shot clock went off? That's the other side of the argument.
And they're going to give it to, it did not touch the rim. It's Detroit ball.
See, the ball was short that time, and Rodman got the ball. But look, they just changed it, made the ball.
Must have been off of the glass.
From that angle, it's difficult to see whether it caught it or not.
And the call on offensive foul. Away from the ball against Dennis Rodman, I believe, and that'll be two on Rodman. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar goes to the bench and is replaced by Michael Thompson.
When you're Dennis Rodman, you cannot be the leading rebounder throughout the playoffs unless you want to sacrifice your body, and he gets it on his man as quick as possible.
Thompson played a tremendous effort game in game number three off the bench. Rivers misses, Lambeer outlet. Dumars. Rivers has to take that open shot.
Oh, they'll challenge him, but, you know, he's a proven college scorer. They'll make him take his shot, but he is a good shooter.
Rodman is down, and his back is hurting him.
Yes, he is, right here, right in front of us.
He takes the shot and hits the shot, but he is holding onto his back. As you know, he has back spasms and is an obvious pain. Stays in it, though.
He says it's like putting a screwdriver into your back and then screwing it if the muscles get tight.
Technical foul has been called against Chuck Daly by Earl Strom, and Rodman's going to have to come out of the game.
If Rodman comes out, Dick, this is a major loss. He is the primetime rebounder. You'll see right here, Dennis Rodman is blocking out A.C. Green on this rebound. And now once, just watch him as he's running down the floor. He'll get across half court. He looks like he has a nice gait about him. But now watch what starts to happen. You can see the back. He'll go right to his knees to the corner. And you'll see that he probably is having a bad spasm.
Right now, let's check over with Pat O'Brien. Patrick?
Maybe that's exactly what he's having. The stab to the back has re-injured that back. This problem came about during the Chicago series, and Dennis has been playing with that pain throughout this series. As you can see, the pain is quite acute now, but the doctors here say it is correctable. They'll put some ice on it, and we'll follow that story for you. Back to you.
I remember when he got hurt against Chicago, and he was really in pain, and he went out and had 15 rebounds in that one. But Chuck Daly sees problems early on, gets hit with a technical foul, and Michael Cooper is on the line. Meanwhile, Orlando Woolridge has come in for the Lakers, and with Rodman out of there, Mark O'Dwyer, who picked up two early personal fouls, has to check back in for Detroit. 9-point lead. Woolridge seeing his first action tonight. Lakers expect some scoring from him off the bench. Worthy. Travel.
Excellent idea.
Meanwhile, Worthy with 14 points, red hot, has hit all seven of his shots. Dumars leads Detroit with six. We're winding down to 2 minutes to go. Well, we had a brief skirmish between Mahorn and Cooper. Rodman had to go out with injury. Lakers with the early lead of nine. Cooper knocks it away from Vinnie Johnson. Rivers handling the ball. Worthy looking for an open man. They doubled him momentarily. 12 on the shot clock. Worthy lost the ball, and they'll call the foul. Detroit has been in the penalty for a long while, and that foul will be against Isaiah Thomas, his first.
It's one of the very few times that we have seen Detroit be able to get to Worthy for the double team before he got, you know, before he got to the hoop.
What are the Lakers doing right offensively so far?
It's the best movement that we have seen in the last three games, especially when you consider the fact that Scott and Magic are out of there. Now, the thing that you like is that they have an outside game as well as an inside game down in that painted area.
And so far, they have kept defensively those guards quiet. But, of course, they can explode. Dumars with 21 points in the third quarter on Sunday, and then Vinnie Johnson with 13 in the fourth. Worthy makes one free throw, and the lead is 10. That is the biggest the Lakers enjoyed in this opening period. McGuire missed everything. Michael Thompson into the hands of Rivers. Woolridge. And Woolridge gives the Lakers a lead of 12 with 1:20 to go.
If I'm Chuck Daly, I'm concerned about my transition defense. Detroit is lagging behind tonight.
Vinnie Johnson trying to get going. Out of bounds, still Pistons ball. Woolridge and Michael Thompson, two teammates, were battling for it and lost it. Got a new clock to work with. Vinnie Johnson, Sally, and the foul will be against Woolridge, and that'll put the Lakers in the penalty. But Sally seemed to hurt his arm going in for the stuff shot.
See, what you like in a player, excellent vision by Vinny. As soon as Vinny Johnson saw the double team, he dropped the pass off to Sally. His movement was to the glass. But what you like to see them do in that situation is catch the ball, dunk it with two hands so that we're guaranteed the field goal and the foul shot.
Let's see where it happened.
Watch the double team. There it is now. As he elevates, you see? There it is. He catches the arm plus the foul.
It's a good thing they have those rims that give. They didn't always have that, either.
Great for those. See, what just happened now is it puts the pressure on you every time to go to the line and to make the two foul shots.
Cooper controlling the ball with under a minute to play in the first period. Rivers inside to Michael Thompson, who lost it out of bounds. Look at the look on Pat Riley's face. One thing about the Lakers, Rivers can penetrate and dish out. Not normally the L.A. style, but they're going to have to go to it with Rivers in the lineup and Campbell in foul trouble. Meanwhile, the Pistons have only one basket in the last 5 minutes. They break that string as Sally gets in.
Like we said early, every time that the Lakers double team on the wings, Detroit is finding the free people.
15 on the shot clock, 24 in the game clock. Worthy, still 17 first quarter points for Worthy.
I think we have to look for a better word than hot. This guy is really, really smoking.
There's a word. Good for you. 35 points, by the way, is the Lakers' highest scoring quarter in this series. 4 seconds to go in the quarter. Cummings misses, and the buzzer sounds, and the crowd likes what they've seen so far. Johnson and Isaiah Thomas in the backcourt. James Edwards with his first appearance of this game. Misses the shot for rebound by Cooper. Mark McGuire is in there along with Rick Mahorn, the two starters at forward for Detroit. David Rivers remains the point guard. Cooper, the shooting backcourt man. And Woolridge with Thompson and Worthy. Woolridge fights his way in. Rebound by Edwards. 35 points, not only the most for the Lakers in the series, but the highest total for either team in any quarter. And they're going to get Woolridge with the foul. That's his second personal.
I didn't think that Aguirre really had any area to go that time. Woolridge, you know, questioning the call. He thought that he took away the baseline move.
Aguirre. Good defense that time by Woolridge. Out of bounds, it's Lakers ball. The leading scorer for the Pistons, Dumars and Sally each with 6. Worthy with 17 at nearly half of the 35 Laker total. He missed his first shot, then hit his last 8.
One matchup to watch is Aguirre on Woolridge.
Mahorn is guarding Worthy now, and he'll play him physically. Worthy misses after hitting 8 in a row. Rebound, Vinny Johnson. Pistons trail by 12. Aguirre. Worthy clears.
Detroit needs Aguirre to get going here and give them some outside perimeter shooting.
Edwards, Thomas, Vinny Johnson, and Aguirre. They have 4 offensive players in the Detroit lineup. And a 3-point basket by Cooper. That's his 9th of this series, so he's come through long range, Hubie.
He's playing well.
Thomas going strong to the hoop, has it blocked by Woolridge, but a foul is called. It'll be against the Lakers, of course. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar replaces Worthy, who gets a hand. Worthy goes out having scored 17. Here's Pat O'Brien.
Dick, of a check on Dennis Rodman. They're still icing his back, as you can see there. He has a spasm. They're quite painful, but he will play again, and they're just trying to loosen him up a little bit, and that's what's happening there.
Thank you, Pat.
See, with Mahorn going out early in the quarter, Dick, and then also Rodman having back troubles, that was a major reason also to help Worthy get off the a big jump.
He missed the second, made the first. So Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, as you saw back in the game, Worthy getting his first breather with a superb first quarter. Rivers picked up the personal, his first. Here's Michael Thompson, and fouled by James Edwards inside. Edwards, of course, who was originally drafted by the Lakers and was traded in a deal that sent Adrian Dantley, of all people, to the L.A. Lakers. And strange roads that players travel, don't they?
Well, you know, he was a 3rd-round draft pick out of the University of Washington, and Kareem really helped his game. And, you know, he contributes to Kareem. He was in competition, you know, not with him, but trying to be the backup center, and Kareem told him, you know, perfect that fadeaway jump shot, James. It's unstoppable.
He did, and it is.
Yes. You don't go 11 years in this league averaging double figures without some good offensive moves.
The lead is 16 now by the Lakers. Illegal defense called against L.A., so that's the first one. It's a warning. Look at the shooting by Detroit by 7-minute span.
Well, if you notice, Detroit cannot get inside of the painted area or get near the rim. They're either being fouled or they're getting to force off some pretty tough shots.
Cooper trying to keep Vinny Johnson within reason. Plenty of time on the clock. Vinny Johnson hits. They were in his face in the fourth quarter. The Lakers were wondering, what could they do against him? And he just continued to fire and score.
Well, Vinny says, when I'm hot and I'm on fire, I get in that zone. It doesn't matter who's on me and where his hand is.
Michael Cooper, 2-point basket that time. But Cooper has hit 2 perimeter shots now. 42-26.
They must get up on Cooper and force him to put the ball on the floor.
Vinny Johnson shooting over Kareem. But here's Edwards. Knocked away, and it will still be Detroit's ball.
Excellent deflection that time by David Rivers. Went right in there.
And they've all performed well in this series. Rodman with the rebounding. Sally. Vinny Johnson and James Edwards.
See, right now, the Laker offense, Dick, is really putting and straining this group of people. There's the key guy in this bench control, because when he's in there with Sally, they have their two SWAT men, the shot blockers, the guys that run the lanes for them extremely well.
Looks like Rodman is trying to make sure he's all right and getting set perhaps to return to the game shortly. Vinny Johnson. Lakers are up by 16.
The major success here is Detroit can't score, and the Lakers are holding them to one shot.
Kareem finds Rivers. He has to continue to take that shot. He's missed them all thus far. But he's come in and has had to play a lot of minutes with Tony Campbell, the starting guard, on the bench with three personal fouls.
Detroit must stay within their continuity offensive stuff, because right now they're kind of struggling. They're not getting good shot opportunities. Give the Lakers credit. They're doing an excellent job defensively.
Three on the shot clock and a foul. Dumars tries to work his way on the baseline. The shooting so far with a huge edge to Los Angeles. 64% to only 41 for Detroit. That foul is on David Rivers, his second. Dumars is on the line.
See, there's a term in basketball, bodying up. Anytime that you're playing a dribbler, if you can get away with it, you're trying to play him from the waist down with your legs as you're bumping him and then getting a hand on him also. Now, we are seeing that with the Lakers tonight. They're coming out, they're establishing that they're going to be physical. Now, so when it does get called, they put you on the line. But if it doesn't get called, they force you into some bad shot attempts.
And Robin's one of the best at bodying up on the Detroit side. Dumars hits the free throws. Dumars is averaging nearly 29 a game in this series. 3.5 minutes gone by in the second quarter. Dick Stockton and Hubie Brown. Game four of the NBA Finals. Woolridge fights his way in. You're seeing some people you wouldn't expect to see in a final, like David Rivers, the rookie, because Magic Johnson and Byron Scott are unable to play. McGuire finally gets a basket. He had not hit one in the last two games before that jumper. Waiting to come in is James Worthy, who had 17 first quarter points. Kareem in good position. Open is Rivers. And Johnson. So Rivers is 0 for 4 from the field. Mahorn. Basket counts and a foul as Cooper. And Mahorn had a little contact going in. Here's Worthy, who hit 8 in a row at one time in the first quarter, will replace David Rivers. And right now, here's Pat O'Brien. Pat?
Dick, in the last two Detroit huddles, there have been three subjects. James Worthy, James Worthy, and James Worthy. Back to you.
So I would deduce that the subject was James Worthy. Wouldn't you think so?
Well, they're still within excellent striking distance here. The defense just has pulled itself together.
Michael Thompson goes in for the layup. Last touch by a Laker. 44-32. Pat Riley's team had a 16-point lead. Now the Pistons trying to come back. 7:25 remaining in the half.
Main thing is with Detroit is stay within your offense and attack the basket.
Johnson with a good fake on Worthy. Another basket and a foul. They missed a chance for a three-point play a few moments ago and can do it again.
What you're trying to do by what I just said is keep attacking. Force the Lakers to continue to challenge and challenge in the shot-blocking area. As the fatigue factor enters in, instead of shot blocks and maybe intimidation, what you do is you get fouled.
Michael Thompson picks up his first foul and goes to the sidelines, replaced by A.C. Green. Pistons now have scored 7 in a row. They've cut the lead to 9. And a timeout called by the Lakers. A good timeout called by Pat Riley. I think even the coach Hubie Brown would agree to keep shooting Detroit and also out rebounding them. James Worthy got him off to a hot start with 17 points in the first quarter. But Hubie Brown, the Pistons have cut the lead now, and of their 12 points in the quarter, 8 have come from the big three, the three musketeers of Dumars, Thomas, and Vinnie Johnson.
Well, because they're taking it down in there, they're already shooting the one-on-one, the bonus roll. So we know that Chuck Daly likes the movement, likes what's being created. But then when you're on the road, it always comes down to two things: your shot selection and your defense at the other end of the floor.
Meanwhile, at the last timeout, this was Dennis Rodman running the baseline to see if his back is all right. He had to come out in the first quarter, and he gave the nod to Mike Abdenauer. I can go back in. Meanwhile, the Pistons go with the same five. Rodman, Dumars, Edwards, Mahorn, and Aguirre. Kareem is fouled, and if it's Edwards, that'll be James Edwards. Second personal foul, and the Pistons second.
Well, Detroit continues to play Kareem one-on-one every time he catches the ball low. And if that would continue, you know that Kareem can get a shot anytime that he wants.
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, two-time MVP in the NBA Finals, and he got them 14 years apart. Most people don't even have careers half that long. This is the second. The lead is 10 for the Lakers.
The Lakers are in their half-court trap now.
Trying to get the ball out of the hands of those three guards. Mahorn in the corner. They double-team Vinnie Johnson. Dumars fires the jumper. Rebound by Orlando Woolridge. He's been a tiger off the boards.
He's been really skying tonight.
Worthy. Guarded by Dumars on a mismatch. In the low post. Kareem with the skyhook off the mark. Green got tied up and the Pistons come back. 2-on-4, but there's Vinnie Johnson slicing his way up and drawing the foul. Normally, Dumars does guard Worthy, but when they're solo in the low post, that's an advantage for Worthy. Woolridge with the personal foul, that'll be his third. So Woolridge picks up a tough third here.
Now, this is a big decision for Pat, but he's going to stay with Woolridge right now because he feels he's making a big contribution. You know, when you're dealing with bench guys, you always must realize that, hey, let them take their fouls. Don't worry about them if they're making a contribution, because you still have your first unit players to play later on in the game.
But because his bench is depleted without Magic and Byron Scott, if they get into foul trouble, he really is hurting, and David Rivers will replace Woolridge, who goes out with three fouls.
Well, he thought that one over for quite a while.
Tony Campbell, who started at guard, has not come back after picking up his third. So Pat Riley really has to mix and match now to hang in there. Fortunately for him, he has a lead of 9.
Well, see, it's a major decision for a coach to make there right now. Does he want to stay big or does he go small?
Vinnie Johnson misses the free throw. Magic and Tony Campbell conversing. Nearly halfway through the second period. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Cooper with a high arcing shot missing.
Give Detroit credit. They're starting to really strangle the offense now, forcing bad shots.
Sooner or later they do it. Lately it's been later, the fourth quarter. James Edwards. Rebound AC Green. Rivers, rookie from Notre Dame. Kareem, and they'll call it on Edwards, and that'll be 3 on James Edwards.
See, James is getting to Kareem early, and he's, you know, trying to get position on him, and if Kareem is on the move, he's blocking him and not allowing him to go to his favorite spot. That's why we're having collisions here.
So Bill Laimbeer, whose best offense is from the perimeter, replaces Edwards, whose best offense is from inside. There's the story with the fouls. Dumars stays with Rivers. Cooper doubled. Detroit really doing well, switching and hanging in with their men.
They're doing an excellent job with their feet, Dick.
The Going baseline, Worthy. Another sensational foray by James Worthy, 19. He scored 26 to lead the Lakers in their last game after getting under 20 in the first two contests. Dumar with a tough shot over David Rivers.
That is a tough shot, but you know, he looks to swish it from that angle, and it's really interesting. He plays the board so well that it surprises you.
We have seen a lot of tough plays by Joe Dumars on the offensive end. Six on the shot clock now for the Lakers. Kareem to Rivers in the lane, and he hits his first basket after missing his first four.
Excellent feed by Kareem, finding him open.
A well-played game, really, at both ends for both teams so far in this half. Dumar getting hot, hits a second in a row, and he's got 12 to lead Detroit.
And I must say, a very quiet 12.
That's right.
Okay?
You look up and you said, really?
That's right.
Under 4 minutes now to go in the half.
See, everything that's happening for the Lakers is down within the last 5 seconds.
Rebound by Aguirre as Kareem yelling for a foul. Vinny Johnson comes up empty, and it's Lakers ball. Michael Thompson is going to check back in the game now for the Lakers. And now they've changed it. It's going to be Detroit ball. Here's that Rivers play earlier.
He just hits the free man open, and they're saying, hey, David, you must knock down that shot.
Bora and Al Alcindor, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's parents here. Johnson fouled going to the hoop. Lakers are in the penalty. Kareem has left the game, replaced by Michael Thompson. And by the way, we want to tell you at halftime, you must sit and watch a tribute to Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, which charts his career from his grade school days through college in the NBA. Poignant. And Hubie, all of us watched it this afternoon, and emotional to say the very least at halftime.
A very moving and outstanding tribute, and I think that the people will love the sincerity of the contributors.
Vinny Johnson misses the free throw. One. Both teams have struggled from the line somewhat. Pistons have missed 8 of 20. 8-point lead for the Lakers now with less than 3.5 minutes to play in the opening half. 7 on the shot clock. Michael Thompson is knocked away by Lane Beer. Better hurry. Rivers loses it. They're not going to get it off, and a loose ball foul. Is it a foul or turnover?
Loose ball foul.
Yep. That's 3 on David Rivers. So 3 of the Lakers. Rivers, Campbell, and Woolridge now hampered with 3 personal fouls.
Well, see, Rivers is upset with himself because, A, he knew that he had a turnover going right there. Then he compounded the situation by causing a foul. But if you ask him, he probably would say, I didn't want them to go out on a 2-on-1.
Here's Dumars on the line with 12 points in the game. He has scored 30 or more in 2 of the 3 games thus far. Jeff Lamb replaces David Rivers. Give you an idea how deep Pat Riley has to go into his bench without his starting guards in there this series.
Well, Jeff Lamb is an outstanding perimeter shooter out of the University of Virginia. He's been around the league for a number of years. He can knock them down if he's open.
And the woes from the line for the Pistons continue.
Give the Pistons their credit, Dick. Their defense in the last 5 to 6 minutes, outstanding.
Well, the Lakers have scored only 14 points in the second quarter. Getting down under 3 minutes. Worthy. And up Green on the offensive glass by Michael Thompson. But Lane Beer winds up with it, and it'll be Detroit ball. L.A. obsessed with keeping the ball alive.
We're seeing great competition here by both groups on the boards.
Do you know what makes that Eagle Summit special?
It's incredible. Dual warranty.
You got it.
Unbelievable room.
You got it.
I just wish it had a lower price.
You got it.
You know, ball players learn superstitions early. Some guys rub their bats for luck.
Good kid.
Some guys always wear rally hats. Others pat the catcher's head. Me, I take my relief pitcher to Pizza Hut before every game.
Now buy a Pizza Hut pizza and get a relief pitcher for just $2.49. Then get free Pepsi fill-ups all summer with any dinner-sized pizza to go. Every pitcher sold helps support Little League of America.
With a great relief pitcher, maybe you don't need superstitions.
Pizza Hut! Make it a great...
Filtered, never heat pasteurized, Miller Genuine Draft. For those who've discovered its smooth, real draft beer taste, the world is a very cool place. So tap into the cold. Cold filtered Miller Genuine Draft.
Give me one good reason why you chose the Eagle Premier.
High-tech engine, roominess, aerodynamics, European design.
I only asked for one.
Take your pick.
Picturesque Mount Wilson, the San Gabriel Mountains. That is a live shot. The Lakers have basically been unscathed injury-wise throughout their great reign of the 1980s. In 83, when they were swept by Philadelphia, Norm Nixon, James Worthy, and Bob McAdoo were out. And this year, they are having to do without Byron Scott and Magic Johnson. And the word is that they are both doubtful if the series continues for Game 5 on Thursday night, Hubie.
Yes, but what Pat Riley is seeing now, that this group of people, they got the cobwebs out in Game 3, and they are confident with the combinations that are on the floor for them tonight. But the Detroit defense absolutely murder in this quarter.
They've limited the Lakers to only 14 points in this period, and now L.A. in their trap again. They want someone other than those guards to take shots, Vinny Johnson and Dumars. Dumars driving in with a foul. Let's see if it's A.C. Green. Lakers were in the penalty early, and the Pistons have only three team fouls, and Green picks up his second foul, and Dumars has gone to the line. A good deal in this first half. He's attempting his ninth and tenth shots from the line.
See, when you look at Dumars and Vinny Johnson, you must understand that Dumars is 190 pounds, Vinny Johnson 195. They're very powerful in the upper body. So when they go in there and get hit, they hold their area, and then they release the shot that they can make.
6 of 10 from the line for Joe Dumars. The Pistons at one time were down by 16. They have got 10 points off of that deficit. Lakers have been going deeper into their bench than they wanted to because of foul trouble. That's why Jeff Lamp is in there, and Rivers had to come in early.
Moore not letting Worthy post up, forced him to the corner.
3 seconds on the shot clock. Cooper will have to put it up. He does from three-point land, and Michael Thompson has the offensive rebound and is fouled. That is the fourth team foul against Detroit. They are not in the penalty, and that is on Vinny Johnson, his first.
See, if I'm Pat Riley, you know, you see right down here in the lower part of your screen, you'll see Mahorn pushing Worthy out with good pressure defense.
Worthy. Picked up, I think Michael Thompson will get credit for that basket, and he does.
But I think that Mahorn and Lambeer also had a major part in that one.
It's always good to be around the play.
Absolutely.
Nearly a minute and a half remaining in the first half. Vinny Johnson goes around, and an illegal defense called against the Lakers. That'll be a technical foul. That's their second violation. So the Pistons will go to the line. Pat Riley, 98 playoff career victories. Red Auerbach has 99. Back did it in 16 years. It's taken Pat 8, but don't forget they play a lot more playoff games now than they did back then.
Okay.
I think you were right, Hubie.
Yeah, kind of take a look here at Mahorn. There's Mahorn's hand. Thompson gets a little teensy bit of it. So the closest player gets credit for the field goal anyway.
Lane Beer made the tee, and it's 51-44 now. Detroit, not only have they played defensively solidly lately, they've been scoring on possessions. There's one that drops for Vinnie Johnson. It's a 12 out of 14 now. Possessions, the Pistons have scored.
How about the soft touch on that? Yeah, right here. Mahorn just pop-worthy here. You know, they're both, you know, fighting for position.
Johnson moves Mahorn away. It was against Mahorn, and that'll be his second. But it's interesting how Mahorn is barking at Worthy, and Worthy is trying to use reason here, and as he argued.
Well, just look to the left of your screen. You're seeing a good defensive player, Rick Mahorn, trying to stop Worthy. Now, what happened first? Worthy took that left hand and tried to move Mahorn out of there, but Mahorn's not going to give any ground. He's in there to play defense and to rebound and also to talk to you a little bit and try to disrupt your game.
Dennis Rodman, meanwhile, who had to come out in the first quarter when his back acted up, is all right and back in there now. Worthy hits the free throw. The one thing about James Worthy, not to make any comment about Mahorn because he has his style, is that Worthy stays so cool on the court and you never really see him lose.
Magic Johnson says, Mr. Consistency. He never changes. It's hard to get him out of his focus.
Pretty good description. The lead is 7 for the Lakers. James Worthy walking away with his first personal foul. Again, a shooting situation. Worthy has scored 21, by the way, to lead the Lakers. 17 coming in the first quarter, while Dumars leads Detroit with 14, and here he is on the line again. Made a living on the line. This will be his 11th and 12th attempts in the first half. I guess that proves that the Piston guards have been able to penetrate, particularly Joe Dumars.
Well, every time they're getting tracked, Dick, they're taking it right into the trap and then trying to split it. That's where the fouls are coming.
But as you saw on the graphic, they have struggled from the line, yet they trail by only 5 after being down by 16 with a minute to go in the first half. Vinnie Johnson kicked it away.
I'm sitting here, and I am very impressed with the Detroit defense. They are so quick in this quarter. And like I said, they made up their mind. They have to, you know, shift gears here right now and tighten the bolt.
Michael Cooper with 10 points now, including a 3 tonight. His perimeter shooting is a big boost to the Lakers tonight. There's the time remaining, 55-48 L.A. Vinnie Johnson off the screen. Great feed inside to Dennis Rodman. Didn't get the hoop, but a good pass by Vinnie.
Credit the Laker defense. They made Dennis come up on the other side of the basket that time.
16 on the shot clock. A 9-second differential. With a game clock. Cooper goes for 3. Vinnie Johnson. And the Pistons can play out the first half. Keep in mind, the Lakers led after 3 quarters in the last 2 games, only to see Detroit put the clamps on in the 4th. Vinnie Johnson gets the foul and will go to the line with 2 seconds remaining. Vinnie Johnson has scored 9 points in this half, in this second quarter. Jeff Lamp with his first foul.
The thing that you love to watch with Johnson and Dumars is they level the player off that's playing them. They cross dribble back and forth, and they get the defensive player to relax, and then they decide when they're going to make that major step on the drive to the basket.
Vinnie Johnson, who learned his game on the playgrounds of Brooklyn, New York. And a 20-second timeout called by Pat Riley to design something offensively with 2 seconds to play in the half. If the Lakers survive and win tonight, game 5 will be Thursday night on CBS, beginning at 9 o'clock Eastern time. That'll cap the 3 games played here at the Forum.
Pat Riley right now knows that in 2 seconds, with a good deployment of people, that you can get off, you know, a decent shot with 2 seconds. It will probably be something long or a pass to at least half court. at this end right now, you're looking at Detroit and you say, hey, we're down right now 7 points, but we have missed 11 foul shots, uncharacteristic of us at the playoffs this year.
And I'm sure the Lakers said the same things after game number one when they missed the bucket. Vinny Johnson. 2 seconds to go, and they won't get it off.
Joe Dumars made it.
He's all right.
Yes.
He was hit hard. Let's wait and see as Lane Beer. Vinny Johnson around Joe Dumars. He has been hit, it looks like, the right eye.
That happened as both players elevated to go for that loose ball. You'll see it here as the ball is coming. Here's Joe Dumars running on the inside of Cooper. There it is right there. Boom. He hits his own man.
Mike Abdenauer, the trainer, quickly out, and now he's up. He's got some time to rest, but Hubie, the Piston three guards, scored 21 of their 26 points in the second quarter, so they're getting cooking. And that's the end of the first half with the score, the Lakers 55 and the Pistons 49. Brent Musburger will return with the Prudential at the half after this message.
Come take a flight of fantasy.
Welcome aboard,
CBS Sports presents the Prudential at the half, sponsored by the companies of the Prudential. Come to the Prudential and build your future on the rock.
Well, back at the half, and the Los Angeles Lakers, who blazed away with 35 in the first period, were shut down in the second and held to only 20 points. Joe Dumars here with a collision late in the second quarter, and certainly the Pistons bench and all of the fans for a few moments held their breath that the injury might have been serious, but he appears to be all right as he headed back off the floor. So welcome to the Prudential at the half. I'm Brent Musburger. As you're well aware, if Detroit closes in and it sweeps the Lakers, this would be the last night that Kareem Abdul-Jabbar ever suits up for the Los Angeles Lakers. Little did Al and Cora Alcindor realize back in April of 1947 that their infant son would grow up to become one of the greatest basketball players of all time. Think for a moment about what he's accomplished. 3 NCAA championships at UCLA, 6 NBA titles with Milwaukee and Los Angeles. His name is in the record book 40 times. At the age of 42, he's the oldest player ever in the NBA. And now he is coming to the end of this legendary career. And we would like to pay this special tribute to him.
He was a very spry kid, and he always was into everything, and he loved to talk. He was a cowboy all his life, up until he was about 10. We always had to get him a cowboy outfit at Christmas time. And he always had to have 2 guns.
I had a tryout, and Kareem was in the 5th grade. But then Kareem didn't come back for the tryout. So I seen Kareem. And I said, hey, how come you didn't come out for the basketball team? He said, well, he said, Mr. Hopkins, they told me that you picked the team. So I said, well, you go home and get your sneakers, and I want you out in the court. Kareem came back, and that's how Kareem started playing basketball.
I thought he was special when he was in the 8th grade. Lou took the ball from the foul line, didn't even dribble 1 step, and slam dunked it in the 8th grade from the foul line. And I just said, wow.
This is the park that Kareem and I played in as kids. But what I remember most is times we had other than playing basketball. I remember the time that first time he came to my house, we were in the 5th grade. When my sister looked out the door, she thought he was an adult looking for me. And I was instantly in trouble with my mother because she thought I had done something wrong. You know, when she opened the door, I told him, he's in my class, you know. What? And he was almost 6 feet tall then in the 5th grade.
Lou Alcindor, as he is then known, is considered the best high school player in the country. Not since Wilt Chamberlain have college scouts seen a seven-footer with such awesome talent. After over 100 college scholarship offers, Lou finally chooses UCLA.
It did kind of upset us in a way because we wanted him to stay in the East, and he had all the opportunities. He could have gone to any college he wanted to. And then he insisted on going to Los Angeles, Southern California. And I asked him if he knew where it was, and he said no. But he still wanted to go there.
It was immediately apparent that here was an unusual person. Not unusual just because of his tremendous size and ability and as a basketball player, but he was an unusual person as a person.
Sophomore year, first game. People are curious. They ask, is Alcindor really that good? Alcindor answers with a dazzling array of slam dunks. He scores 56 points in his debut.
We won three NCAA championships with him, and no one had ever done that. And he was, I think, largely responsible. I think we'd have won four if he'd been eligible as a freshman.
Lou Alcindor, just a few moments ago, actually signed a multi-year contract to play professional basketball with the Milwaukee Bucks of the National Basketball Association.
Kareem first came into the league, you know, I don't think he had the confidence. He was a marked person. Anytime you're a great athlete, you come into this league, you're going to get banged around a lot. He had to learn that.
Well, he was, at that point in time, trying to make his mark in the NBA. We all knew, and everybody else knew, that he was expected to do great things. And as a leader, he went out and accomplished those types of things.
Our offense was geared for Kareem to get open, and we did a good job of getting Kareem open. He is the best shot off the pivot I've ever seen, bar none. Kareem has done it better than anybody. I think when it's all said and done, Kareem will probably go down as if not the greatest, one of the greatest centers to ever play the game of basketball. And really, wherever he's gone, he's been a winner. And that's what it's all about.
The Los Angeles Lakers select Irvin Magic Johnson, Michigan State, 6'8", 200 pounds.
2 seconds left, the Lakers down by one.
We had like 2 seconds or 3 seconds to go. They were up by one. Kareem hits a sky hook at the free throw line to win the game. So I'm going crazy. I'm jumping up and down. I'm running. I jump in his arm. I'm holding his arm, neck, everything. I'm choking him. And so we get back into the locker room, and he comes over and says with a stern face, you know, nonchalant, like, Irvin? Do you realize that we have 81 more games? So, you know, remember that. And I like, okay, I'm sorry. <You know. laughs> He's just Kareem, but he's changed. Now when he makes a hoop, he looks for five. He has his hand up looking for you to give him five. He wants the affection, he wants the hug, he wants the pat on the back. And that's so beautiful to see a man who has been so one way all his career change over to say, hey, it's all right to high five. It's all right to hug.
The crowd stands for Kareem to get the ball. Everybody's waving their arms. It's into Kareem. Kareem swing left, right hand, 12-footer, good!
I don't think we will ever see a player approach what this man has been able to do in a winning situation, ever. He is unique. We'll never see an athlete like this in the NBA.
Kareem, you've done so much for others. You've done so much for me, Kareem, and I'm deeply appreciative of all of it. I just wish you happiness.
Thanks.
I guess for remembering us all, because he did remember the people that touched on him, and I thank him very much for that.
I want to thank you for all the championships, all the laughter, the jokes that you played, the hugs and kisses when I was down, and the love that you just created among all of us. You taught us how to win and how to hold our heads up when we lost. Thank you for all the memories. I will always love you from here on out. If I ever never see you again, you my main man.
To play good defense, we got in real early foul trouble, and they got us up, got us down 16, or they were up 16, and we missed 11 free throws. The boards are killing us, 25-13. We don't have an answer for Worthy today.
What do you say to your team now? You're a half away from an NBA title.
Well, they've got to make a decision how hard they want to play defensively. If we're not going to win this game offensively, or going to win it defensively, giving one shot. We would have been close to being tied had we not given up two or three second shots right at the end of the half. But it's all going to be defense.
Good luck in the second
half.
Thank
you.
And by the way, Joe Dumars is okay, and he'll play. Back to you guys.
All right, thank you very much, Pat. And we're getting set for the second half. Looking at the statistics, the Lakers have out-rebounded the Pistons, including off the offensive glass. What has hurt Detroit has been the free throws. They have missed 11, and James Worthy has outscored the entire Detroit front court.
Early going here. Let's see if they try to get Isaiah off.
Isaiah guarded by Cooper. Laimbeer fires a three and hits Bill Laimbeer with a three-point basket. That's his second of the game, and it brings the Pistons to within three. A shocking first shot to start this second half. Tony Campbell with three fouls starting in the backcourt with Cooper. Up front, it's Kareem Abdul-Jabbar with Worthy and Green. Usual Pistons starters with Aguirre and Mahorn and Laimbeer. Dumars and Thomas, and a three-point basket answered by James Worthy, who has 24 points.
You and Mom, how about that relationship? Still have some rough times?
Yeah.
You tell us.
For two. There's the foul trouble. Campbell, Woolridge, and Rivers of the Lakers with three. Edwards and Mahorn of the Pistons. This try for the steal, and instead is a Detroit foul. And Laimbeer gets called for it. That'll be his first.
I think Chuck Daly, you know, he was definitely right on the money. He's disappointed in his early first quarter defense, but he knows that the ball club accepted the challenge, came right back, give them what they're famous for, hard nose, yeah, limit you to one shot, and then also force you into bad shots.
It's a very big quarter for the Lakers. Michael Cooper misses the shot long range. Laimbeer the rebound. They had a 16-point lead that had been cut down to three. Now it's four, but the Pistons have been coming on in this one.
You can't beat Detroit over 48 minutes from outside.
Battle for the loose ball. Mahorn lays it in.
How about that? Isaiah Thomas over the back of Kareem kept that one alive, which enabled Mahorn to get the score.
Meanwhile, Kareem has scored only 3 points in this game. He had 24 in the last one. When you talk about inside scoring, that's where the Lakers need something. Cooper sets for the three. Campbell throws it into the hands of Thomas. It's a 4-on-2 break for the Pistons. What great play by Worthy on the layup attempt by Joe Dumars.
James Worthy timed that perfectly that time. He did not go for the block until Dumars released the ball. He was right there.
58-56. The Pistons have never had the lead in this game. 9:45 remaining in the third. Dumars following. And the basket counts and a foul. Again, they defensed him as good as you could want, and he scored anyway.
Watch as he comes off this dribble. You'll see Tony Campbell right now. Watch how he elevates. There's the bump, and then he moves out. See, the good offensive players will initiate the contact with their left shoulder, then fade out because of their jumping ability and strength and go for that shot.
And Dumars can give Detroit its first lead of the game. He has been on the free throw line 14 times already tonight. And he's got it, and the Pistons lead it 59-58. And the big loss for the Lakers is Byron Scott, because his defense against the point guard and their penetration may be the biggest thing L.A. misses in this series.
Yeah, I agree with that, Dick. And then also the three-point shooting of Magic Johnson along with Byron Scott.
Kareem trying to get underway, hacking at the ball, and getting it away is Isaiah Thomas.
They're tenacious right now defensively.
Feed inside Mahorn. And Mahorn scores, and the Pistons are on a roll now, leading by three.
They need a timeout, Dick. Get themselves organized.
And Pat Riley will call a timeout as the Pistons have scored seven straight.
Rob, last night, I think I was robbed. For the first time in history of boxing for me, I was robbed.
What do you think of this game, Thomas? What about the Pistons tonight?
I think the Pistons are great. I think that the Pistons still have an opportunity to pull this game out. And I think they can be successful tonight.
Give us a scoop. A rematch, World War III?
We're working on that right now. I'm sure it will be World War III.
Great job last night. Thanks for joining us. Back to the game, the other war.
All right, Pat, thank you very much. Well, after a draw, you want to get somebody to win that thing, Hubie, right?
Oh, it was great entertainment.
Let's see how the Lakers answer a seven-point run by the Pistons. James Worthy, who's playing big tonight now with 26.
He's the only Laker in double figures, Dick. They're straining. They're looking around for help for him.
That matches his point total in game three and a foot block and a new 24-second clock for Detroit. Dumars with 19 is the Pistons' high score, with Vinnie Johnson second with 10. Isaiah Thomas has five. Tony Campbell playing with four fouls. Dumars goes right around him, but the shot is blocked by A.C. Green. That's what the Lakers need to do when the guards penetrate. They have to close in fast. They did there.
Well, Tony Campbell must lay off him a little bit, or he's going to get in foul trouble again.
Kareem. Still struggling offensively.
Look out.
Thomas feeding left here, lays it in, foul, as well as the basket. And the Pistons lead now 63-60 and a chance to add another. James Worthy now with his second foul, and Michael Thompson will replace Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, who has yet to hit a basket tonight.
Center position has been sparse in point production for the Lakers. I was disappointed on the defense on that play. See, the Pistons are looking for the fast break on every defensive rebound, and they're getting out 3-on-2, 4-on-2 now. The Lakers must beware.
So Detroit is up by four. That's a 20-point turnaround since the second quarter when the Lakers were up by 16. Mahorn trying to cut down Worthy. Lakers look like they don't know where to go offensively right here.
Well, I'll give the Pistons credit. They're denying the passes on the ball reverse.
Worthy hits a three-point basket, second one of the game, and he's got 29. And it's almost a one-man gang on offense for L.A. right now.
When have we ever seen James Worthy take a number of threes in a game? Never mind knock them all down.
Dumas gets by Campbell and draws the foul. That'll be the fourth team foul against the Lakers, the Pistons with only one. And Tony Campbell has picked up number five, and he'll have to come out of there.
He's playing him too tight, Dick. He should lay off him. He has 4 inches on Dumars. You can lay off him and then guard him with your arm reach. All he's trying to do is bang him and bang him. All it became for him now is a night of frustration.
He's replaced by Orlando Woolridge, so Campbell is... with five fouls, has scored only 6 points, and here's a guy who's been in double figures in all three games of the series thus far.
Well, they were looking for him to be that possible third guy, and also the center position. They're getting nothing out of the second guard or that position.
Joe Dumars, again the leading scorer for the Pistons, as he was in games two and three. He makes them both, and he is 13 of 17 from the line. So that's where he's gotten most of them. 3-point lead for the Pistons. 7:15 to go in the third quarter.
See, with this group out on the floor, the only guy that's a low post player is James Worthy.
Woolrich is strong to the hoop and will go to the line. That's Lane Beer's foul. It'll be his second and the second team foul against Detroit.
See, if you're going to play without post up players, then the guys on the floor must be able to take people off the dribble if you cannot free them out of your offensive sets. Now, Orlando Woolrich can do it for you.
That's what Worthy has done to keep the Lakers alive here. They trail 3-0. They were swept in 1983 by the Philadelphia 76ers. Lou Gossett, one of the many celebrities in the crowd today to see if LA can hang in there. But Detroit looking awfully tough right now as they call traveling against Mark McGuire. But if you're Chuck Daly, you've got to like the situation right now. The score, you're up by one. And the way the flow of the game is going.
Oh, absolutely. You have definitely set the tempo here and for the last quarter and a half.
Thomas from behind. Third team foul against Detroit. Two against Isaiah.
See, tonight the Lakers cannot reverse the basketball from one side to the other. If they have nothing on one side, they want to reverse it, but they're getting denied. Now, what is happening is the shot clock is moving, and then they are put into tough situations with the clock.
And Worthy again from the baseline. And 31 points for James Worthy. The Lakers have regained the lead. He is 4-for-4 this period. One time he hit 8 in a row in the opening stanza. Nearly stole the ball from Dumar. 9 on the shot clock. Thomas trying to get free and he's going for an offensive foul.
He definitely wrapped his left arm around the defensive player in order to get free that time. Earl Strom right on the call. You'll see him now. Watch the left hand. There it is. He cleans out right there.
Thomas with 3 personal fouls. He has scored only 5 points. Dumars again the big gun. Now Isaiah defending against Cooper. On the pick and roll with James Worthy. Out of sight tonight is James Worthy.
The bag of tricks has been opened. He's doing it all.
Timeout, Detroit.
Watch the head fake. Now the dipsy do as he's coming through here.
And a big 33 for Boy to sweep against the very tough and strong Detroit Pistons. Perhaps the best defensive team we've ever seen in the NBA. The Lakers cling to a 3-point lead. Playing without Urban Magic Johnson, who has the hamstring pull. But when people step back and look at this decade, they'll be looking at the Lakers' dominance. And it was sparked by Urban Magic Johnson with the championships. And it started in 1980 when he was forced to play center with Kareem out with an injury. And all of the others, 5 NBA titles this decade, and Urban Magic Johnson was at the center of all of them.
I like what Al Davis from the Los Angeles Raiders has to say. Magic Johnson dominates winning like no other athlete.
But one who knows. Dumars working against Worthy. Double team now. Good defense. Michael Thompson helped. And the Lakers' Cooper has it.
Are they asking James Worthy now to guard Joe Dumars?
Well, you know, Dumars has had to guard Worthy
That's
in this
right.
series. Why not? Worthy finds Thompson. Short hook misses. Mahorn the rebound. With 5:20 to go in the third. Thomas has been quiet offensively. And he'll draw the foul going in. He'll go to the line.
Watch the movement of the feet here by James Worthy as he cuts off the lane. And then the long arms. There's your trap with Thompson.
The foul is on Michael Cooper, his third. And that's the 15th foul. They're in the penalty right now. Isaiah Thomas, who used to pump Magic Johnson and attended all of the championships here at the Forum. He saw the 5 titles. He was here for 4 of them, and he wanted to know from Magic Johnson, what does it take to win a title? And he said that he learned a lot there. He also read Pat Riley's book, Showtime, as did Chuck Daly.
I think Isaiah says it best. It's a mindset. That's what it's all about.
Cooper runs into Laimbeer. The Lakers have it with 8 seconds on the clock. Here's Worthy again. Green out of nowhere lost the ball. Laimbeer to Thomas to acquire. Great defense by Worthy. He's claiming goaltending, but it was a great defensive play by James. Cooper blocked by Laimbeer, and they'll call the foul on Bill.
That's good foul by Laimbeer. He's not going to allow Cooper to go in. Chuck Daly very upset. Let's let the fans make their decision here right now. Here's the shot. Here comes Worthy. There's your hit. He did not pin it. He hit it off the board.
So Michael Cooper is on the line, and Laimbeer picks up his third foul. Pistons with 14 fouls. L.A. is already in the penalty.
Boston.
Cooper bats the ball away in disgust. He has scored 10 points. He's the only other Laker behind Worthy's 33 in double figures. One out of two. Lakers by a pair. Woolard picking up Dumars on the switch. Here's Isaiah Thomas. Throws the ball away into Green's hand, but it's going to be Lakers' ball anyway.
Great anticipation by A.C. Green. Came about 6 feet to get that ball.
But the Lakers are closing in better inside than they have at any game thus far.
But that's how they started out the first quarter. Remember we said you have to sustain it for the entire half.
Pistons had a 4-point lead in this quarter, but the Lakers have come. Michael Thompson short with it. Rebound by Laimbeer. Isaiah Thomas in the lane. Tipped up. Mahorn knocks it off of Green or Woolridge, and it's still Pistons ball.
Outstanding play by Rick Mahorn. He knew he was behind the backboard, losing his balance, threw it off a defensive player.
Dennis Rodman and Vinnie Johnson will check in for Detroit. Rodman, who aggravated a back injury in the first quarter, and Vinnie Johnson, who scored all 10 of his points in the second period. See how the Lakers defense him. They got Worthy out on him. Plenty of time on the shot clock. 12 seconds. Mahorn over Michael Thompson. Big basket for Detroit.
Well, a lot of people underestimate Rick Mahorn. He can post up. He's an excellent scorer, and he has a beautiful jump shot facing the basket.
Has 10 points. That's his best scoring game of the series. 3.5 to play. We're tied at 70. Woolridge breaks the tie for the Lakers.
The Lakers need Woolridge to step forward. He's a proven scorer in this league. 17 points a game over his entire career. He could help them big now.
Vinnie Johnson in the lane. What a rapid release. You're talking about two quick guys against each other. Vinnie Johnson and Worthy, and he's got it out lightning quick to tie it again.
Vinnie's in total command of his release. That was beautiful to watch.
There's really no stopping him when he's on.
Well, he fears no defense.
Woolridge strong with the hoop. And Orlando Woolridge now has scored 10 points coming off the bench, and this is his best scoring game of the series. Back and forth they go. The Lakers are up by two, with nearly 2.5 to play in period number three. Vinnie Johnson thinks he's on a roll. That's over the top, turns it over to the Lakers.
That's one of the very few bounces that Vinny has not got. Chuck is saying, whoa, wait a second. Slow down here right now. Let's keep moving the ball and take up some clock and get a better shot.
Both teams at 50% or better from the field in this quarter.
Yeah, but Vinny said, wait a second, Chuck. I've been knocking that one down all through the playoffs.
When he's hot, you let him knock him down. Even if one goes over the top. 8 on the shot clock. Worthy strong to the hoop. And a foul against Detroit.
See, any time that the Lakers penetrate and go to the basket like that, beat their man, and the rotation comes, that is opening up the Lakers' man who left to get on the offensive boards.
That's the fifth team foul against the Pistons. Here's the free throw shooting of the game. The Lakers have missed just four. And the second on Vinny Johnson. A.C. Green on the line. He had his tooth loosened in the early on in this series. Came back. This has been a war of attrition, it seems, because on the Pistons you have Rodman, Blaine Beer, and Isaiah Thomas have had various ailments and injuries, and of course the Lakers playing without Scott and Magic Johnson, and Green got shaken up too earlier. There's Isaiah and McGuire and Sally on the Detroit bench. Kareem, he'll be seen before the end of the game, and the Lakers hope he gives them some low post offense. Hasn't yet. Detroit's had a lot to say. Green makes one of two. LA by three, and we're down now to 2 minutes remaining in the third quarter.
The Lakers are in their trap for the first time this half.
Dumas drives in, tips. Rodman keeps it alive. Bad back and all. He had 19 rebounds to tie a career, but that's a playoff mark. Great behind-the-back pass, Dumas to Lane Beer, out of bounds, Lakers ball. They had their chances.
That was a beautiful pass by Dumas behind the back that time. Remember, any time that a team is in a trap, if you put the ball down on the floor, you know they're very susceptible to getting beat.
L.A. by three. Here's Worthy again. O'Horn in the corner. Are you surprised L.A. hasn't gone more to the trap in this game?
Well, you know, Pat is playing his combinations, and he's done an excellent job so far because Detroit is outstanding at rotating the ball to the free man.
Vinny Johnson to Lane Beer. Gets Worthy to leave his feet. Hits the jumper. Bill Lane Beer with 14 points. That's his best game of the series offensively. Under a minute now to play in the third. Wilridge around a screen. Inside, Michael Thompson. Fine passing by the Lakers. They're up by three. Desperation time for the Lakers against a very tough Detroit Pistons club. Vinny Johnson drives and gets the hoop. He's got 14.
Challenged three players that time to lay that one up.
Inside Michael Thompson, and he'll call Lane Beer for his fourth foul.
As long as Michael Thompson stays active and keeps moving, he's quicker than Lane Beer or James Edwards, and he can get them to play behind him. Once he makes the catch, then he's in charge. Watch Vinny Johnson now attack Worthy off the dribble. Here comes one, and now here comes the third player. Look at this. He just challenges A.C. Green at 6'9".
Michael Thompson on the line. Meanwhile, James Edwards has replaced Bill Laimbeer in the Piston lineup. Laimbeer goes out with four fouls. Edwards himself has three, and Worthy getting a breather now. He has scored 33 points. Jeff Lamp, you saw him as replaced.
See, the Achilles heel of the Lakers in games two and three, the foul line in the second half.
Isaiah Thomas back in for Detroit. They're playing for the last shot of this third quarter. Hooper is out for the first time in the last two games. 48 minutes on Sunday. Vinny Johnson fires it up. Edwards the rebound. No basket. So the Lakers now have led after three quarters of the last three games. But Detroit's come on. We'll see what happens now. That's the end of the third with the score of the Lakers 78 and the Pistons 76.
Look at all the stars in the NBA. Pick up your copy of the NBA World Championship video. All the highlights from the All-Star Weekend, wow, through the playoffs,
wow,
and exclusive coverage of the NBA Finals. To order your copy, call 1-800-453-7300. That's 1-800-453-7300.
Wow.
Wow. And welcome back to CBS Sports coverage of the 1989 NBA Finals, Game 4, with the Pistons leading 3-0. And after three quarters, the Lakers are up by 2. Before we start the fourth, let's check in with Pat O'Brien. Pat?
All right, Dick, things happening in both huddles. For one thing, Dennis Rodman continues to play in severe pain, but he says he'll play in it. On the Detroit side, they're saying 12 minutes. They know that the fourth quarter is usually their strong quarter. On that note, on the Lakers side, Gary Vitti just told me he has never seen the Los Angeles Lakers this tired. Back to you guys.
All right, Pat. Well, the Pistons are closing in. L.A.'s hanging on, and Detroit, with that magnificent defense, has held the Lakers to a total of 35 points in the last two games in the fourth quarter. A total of 35. James Worthy. Short from three, and there's Kareem who lays it in. 5 points for Abdul-Jabbar in his first field goal of the game.
The Lakers are going big now when you have Kareem, Thompson, and Woolridge on that front line with Worthy in the backcourt.
And David Rivers, the point guard. So a big lineup other than David Rivers for L.A. James Edwards with Mahorn and Rodman. And a foul inside. That'll be Kareem with his second personal foul. Will send Edwards to the free throw line.
Orlando Woolridge just blocked the shot. He just came out from over the top of the rim. But unfortunately for them, you know, Kareem had already fouled him with a push-off.
You see Edwards on the line. You'll notice the black band in memory of Larry Fleischer, former head of the Players Association, who passed away prior to the playoffs. Vinny Johnson with the loose ball, throws it away. And Edwards lays it in.
You cannot fall asleep with the basketball. Isaiah Thomas created all of that activity by gambling.
Furious. Scrap for the loose ball. 80-79. The Lakers lead down to 1. Michael Thompson. Long range. Kareem boxed out that time. And again, the Lakers offense seems to be solely coming from the perimeter. Edwards inside. Good defense by Kareem. And Worthy to Woolridge gets hung up and is fouled by Isaiah Thomas, who goes wild. That'll be 4 on Isaiah.
The Lakers thought that they had a 3-on-1, but the Pistons were hustling back that time and turned that into a lack of a good shot opportunity. Now watch this defense down inside. Kareem puts a lot of pressure on Edwards. There it is right there. That starts it all. There's your block.
And Woolridge winds up on the free throw line. 11 points tonight for Orlando Woolridge. In fact, this whole playoff series hasn't been without pain. Not only the passing of Larry Fleischer, but Jack McMahon, 36 years. Great basketball figure. Pat Riley's first NBA coach in San Diego, and close connections with Chuck Daly at Philadelphia. Everyone will miss Jack.
Absolutely. Great player at St. John's, a terrific coach, an outstanding evaluator of talent.
Mahorn gets the basket and is fouled as well.
See, with the big lineup in there, you have Worthy out at the guard position. And then any time that someone gets beaten off the dribble, you're relying on quick rotation. Pat Riley said that's what was missing in game 3, the quick rotation. Here's your move. Great move by Rodman. Strong move by Mahorn.
11 points this half by Rick Mahorn, as the Pistons have come back to tie it up. We're early in the fourth quarter. Pat Riley's going to have to go to Tony Campbell with 5 personals early. Mahorn defending Kareem. The sky hook, the rebound by Rodman, and a loose ball foul called against the Lakers. And it's Michael Thompson with another one. That's 2 quick ones for Thompson, 3 in the game.
See, Pat Riley has brought in Tony Campbell now so that they will have 2 legitimate guards back there. Maybe they'll have some smoothness out on the fast break.
Thompson goes out. James Edwards hits a smooth jumper wide open, and the Pistons regain the lead by 2.
The reason why he was open, 4 guys were in there trapped, and 1 guy was in the man-to-man, and that's why that area opened up.
And the Lakers want a 20-second timeout. And the Pistons with the lead of 84-82, and they're now going to make this a full timeout. With summary, the Pistons have missed 12 free throws, but they've gone to the line 15 times more than the Lakers, showing their inside play. James Worthy continues to lead the parade for the Lakers. And the rebound showing Detroit with the edge after L.A. had more boards at the half. And, of course, as you already know, the NBA has gone international in a big way. Great interest as five broadcasts are originating.
Os nossos grandes amigos.
Pick one
obrigado,
up.
Um abraço ao Brasil, professor Mazei. Obrigado à CBS. Muito bem.
That's from Brazil. Over 80 countries have been seeing the NBA final telecast on a delayed basis. I know I was in London several years ago, and I caught the telecast after it was over here, and we were over there, and the people enjoyed there, and it's big stories over in European countries and other places.
Well, everybody's excited about the game of basketball. We have great ambassadors from the college and NBA going over there and teaching the game, and this is also the next link. David Stern and the NBA office have done an outstanding job in expanding their coverage to the country.
Lakers trail by two. Cooper. This is a three, and a rebound into the hands of Edwards. But again, the Lakers are unable to get the ball inside against Detroit's defense. Pistons are on an 8-2 run here. Fourth quarter has been their quarter. Edwards goes up and is fouled. And that will be the 14th foul against the Lakers. One more there in the penalty, and it was Kareem, and he has three now.
See, James Edwards is basically a hook shooter and a fadeaway jump shot man. But that time, as soon as he made that catch, he wheeled on Kareem and took him strong to the basket.
How many teams have a backup center like a James Edwards? And this is a team that had William Bedford and Darryl Dawkins. They've had a lot of different possibilities, and they've got a good one in Edwards who helped them last year.
Well, last year he stepped forward at crunch time in the last two series. And let's face it, his contribution in the Chicago semifinals was outstanding.
All six of his points have come in this period. Pistons are up by three. Worthy gets in the paint, gets Edwards in the air, and gets the basket. What great balance by James Worthy.
Oh, tough shot. You know, you're stepping underneath the guy who's 7'2" in order to get that shot off.
35 now for James Worthy. Edwards inside, and it's blocked, and a foul against the Lakers again.
Just keep an eye on James Worthy here. Now watch the move. Get the player up. Now step under him, and then adjust your release.
Campbell has fouled out of the game. That's six on Tony Campbell. You mentioned Pat Riley was looking for some offense from him, but he goes out with 6 points.
Well, with the lineup that the Lakers will have on the floor right now, James Worthy will be primarily working at the guard position. They'll have Green and Woolridge at the forwards, and then Kareem in the center.
This was a lineup, whether it be Kareem or Michael Thompson, that the Lakers savored using before the series. But one other thing, Magic Johnson was going to be one of those big people.
Right, but the major problem that they're having is that the Detroit guards are taking these people off the dribble and breaking down the defense.
Well, they would have done that against anyone, I guess.
I think so.
The lead is two for the Pistons. Worthy shot missed, and it's still Laker ball as two Pistons went after it and lost it. Dennis Rodman getting treatment on his back. Aggravated it in the first quarter. John Sally is in there with Edwards and Mahorn up front. Worthy. Exactly the description for him. He's got 37 points.
How about the patience, Dick, to wait out the defensive players to hit the floor before he exploded?
Nearly 4 minutes gone by in the fourth period. Vinny Johnson gets it to James Edwards. The basket counts and a foul. They got the ball into the big center before the rotation took effect.
You must be impressed with the Detroit guards. Now watch this pass by Vinnie Johnson and how strong he attacks the rim right here. Power dunk, but the delivery of the pass off of the triple team by Vinnie Johnson, beautiful.
Edwards now with 10 points, all 10 of it coming here in this fourth quarter as A.C. Green picked up the foul, and it's a three-point Piston lead. Lakers had a 16-point bulge in the second quarter, and Detroit came back.
How about Detroit changing up and giving you a little trap now?
Woolridge gets fouled. Detroit started to put the clamps on their defense after a 35-point first quarter by the Lakers.
Yeah, I like what I saw that time by Detroit. You know, they came out, they said, we have not showed you a 1-2-2 matchup, and we just gave it to you right now, changing the tempo.
Rick Mahorn with his fourth foul and the second team foul against Detroit in the quarter. You know, the Pistons have missed four more free throws than the Lakers, but it seems that the Laker misses are hurting them a lot more.
Because they're missing them now at crunch time, quarter four.
Has to settle for one, and it's a two-point lead for Detroit. Pistons with a six-game winning streak in the playoffs. They're looking for their sixth in a row this year against the Lakers, including regular year. Thomas gets three inside, and Worthy looks at him and says, where did he come from?
He came from behind the backboard and had the presence to reverse spin it off the glass.
It's a four-point lead, and that matches the biggest the Pistons have enjoyed in this one. Cooper throws up an air ball on the runner. Here's Vinnie Johnson. Here's Thomas.
Yes.
He released early on Cooper's shot, and Chuck Daly's Pistons lead at 93-87, and the Lakers call a timeout. And as Magic Johnson can only watch, maybe the critical moments of this game are about to unfold. That's the Palace.
I'm up in the stands with Cora and Lou Elsinger, Kareem's parents, and you've had your eyes closed here more than you've had them open.
Well, I've been saying my prayers.
What do you think as you look at what might be his last game? Any one of these games could be his last game. And what goes through your mind, Mrs. Elsinger?
Yeah, well, I think he's had a fabulous career, and I'm sorry it's ending like this. But if it has to end like this, I can take it.
Lou, are your hopes up? How do you feel, Lou?
Hopes are up. My hopes are up. Not until the last minute.
We're gonna let these guys get back and cheer. Thank you very much. Back to the table. Great family.
Well, he began his career with three straight NCAA titles at UCLA and wanted so much to cap it with three NBA championships with the Lakers. But if it's two out of three and that's what the destiny is, that's not too bad either. Worthy with a left-handed hook goes. He's doing it every which way. 39 points for James Worthy. After the Pistons, who have scored in eight of their last nine possessions, had opened up their biggest lead of 6 points.
The Lakers are going down into their baseline looking for Vinnie Johnson.
Hooper staying with him with 8 seconds on the shot clock. Kareem the rebound. Mahorn tries to tie him up.
If Kareem will get it out, they can fast break.
The lead is four for the Pistons. They hold on and win. They sweep the Lakers. Kareem fouled. And if it's Edwards, it'll be four on James. That is only the third team foul on the Pistons. And now James Edwards has four fouls and Lane Beer on the bench with four.
See, the Lakers have a burden playing with only one guard. It makes their ball handling ability, their ability to beat you off the dribble, and also to run the offensive sets. It's difficult, but they've adjusted. They've been very spirited in these last two games when you think of the fact that they're trying to get away with Worthy at 6'9 as their second guard.
They go inside to Woolridge, blocked by Sally. He's the leading shot blocker on the Detroit team. Isaiah Thomas said, we weren't really there until we drafted Rodman and Sally in 86. We'll call Green with the foul on Edwards. Foul is against Worthy and not Green. This is the Forum in Inglewood, California. A beautiful building that has housed five NBA titles this decade, but the Detroit Pistons are inching closer to their first NBA title. They lead the two-time defending champions 93-89 with 5:38 to go in the fourth quarter. Dick Stockton, Hubie Brown, Brent Musburger, and Pat O'Brien with you here in game four. L.A. trying to avoid getting swept. The lead is five for the Pistons. Here's the time.
Taking him too long.
Worthy. Fouled. He took the shot with 4 seconds remaining on the clock. Basically, the Lakers have not been successful in getting the ball inside. And that'll be five on Rick Mahorn. One more and he's gone. Tony Campbell's already fouled out for the Lakers. So Worthy for two. There's Campbell, who started at guard. Lakers having to do without Byron Scott and Magic Johnson. Worthy needs one free throw to establish his career playoff high of 40 points, but that was a tough miss. And actually, the 40 points would be a career high in any game, regular season or playoff. He's got the 40, but the Lakers still trail by four. Edwards against Michael Thompson. It's a very tough shot from 12 feet out, and all 13 points for James Edwards here in the fourth quarter. You got a glimpse of Phil Davidson, the Pistons owner. Thompson back in as it's rejected. Still Lakers ball.
See the difference in any post play. There's Oscar Feldman, also one of the major owners and on the board of the Detroit Pistons. You'll only see one player here down at this end of the floor. You see two guys challenging defensively.
A pushing foul against the Pistons, and Natty Chuck Daly pacing and walking on the bench.
Well, Chuck was exasperated that time. You never like to see a foul before the ball gets inbounds because it's an automatic two shot.
Michael Thompson shooting. John Sally committed the foul. Both teams are in the penalty now here in the fourth quarter with 4:50 remaining. Detroit did not take the lead until the second quarter with Lee Iacocca sitting next to David Stern, NBA commissioner. You know who he's rooting for.
Now we're seeing the Lakers in their trap now. They want to try to put more pressure on
Sally. Inside, got physical there. Six on the shot clock. Sally gets fouled. And will go to the line and shoot two. Michael Cooper committing that one.
Okay, Pat Riley uptight because the shot clock was down to four. They didn't have anything. It was going to be a four shot. And what you're trying to do is make them shoot over the top of you with pressure. Do not foul the jump shooter.
So John Sally on the line. 68% free throw shooter in the playoffs. Cooper, who has scored 11 points for the Lakers. Michael Cooper played all 48 minutes of game three and was out for about a minute or two in this one. That's all. Detroit's gone to the line 49 times in this game. Their inside performance offensively has been exemplary. Worthy finds Michael Thompson. Thompson with the basket.
Great move by Michael. He attacked the basket strongly that time. From now to the end, you cannot throw up any soft shots.
98-94. The Lakers with another valiant effort, playing without Magic Johnson and Byron Scott. Game close in the last two games, but couldn't beat the strong Detroit team. Thomas with a great move, changed hands in the air to get a big basket.
Once again, the Detroit guards just attack the size factor.
Six players in double figures for Detroit. Four for the Lakers. Woolridge. And A.C. Green missed inside. Vinny Johnson comes out of it. So another opportunity goes by the boards for LA. That Detroit defense doesn't give you much. And a timeout called by the Pistons. There's the time remaining in the fourth quarter, and the Detroit Pistons lead by six.
In this sequence, you'll see Isaiah Thomas take advantage of a mismatch. Watch through the legs. Now as he drops and comes down in here, watch the right hand, how he adjusts the ball. Yes. And gets the bounce.
And right now, let's take a scene up at the Palace of Auburn Hill. And they're going wild up there. Over 20,000 fans at the Palace. Meanwhile, it's a lot quieter in downtown Los Angeles and certainly here at the Forum, where the Lakers are 3 minutes and 23 seconds away from being swept by a defensive team that we have not seen in memory. We were talking about some of the great defensive aggregations in NBA history, and I don't think we've seen a better one. And also 3:23 from the end of one of the great long careers in NBA history, 20 years of Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Thomas double team, stepped on the line, turns it over.
That's one of the few turnovers that the half-court trap has provided for the Lakers in the last two ball games.
Lakers have shot just 29% from the field in this fourth quarter. Pistons 80%. Fourth quarter has been theirs. Six on the clock. Kareem. Sky hook. Hasn't gone for him tonight. And the Lakers have missed it. 100-94. Detroit will use the clock here.
Well, they're exclusively in the trap now. Now, you see Detroit smart. They're just backing it out. Take their time. Move the basketball. And force the mismatch when they go man.
Misses the rebound by Green. Plenty of time remaining, but the Lakers have to do it offensively here. Thompson at the block. And it's taken by Dumars. And it was Mahorn who got the block.
That's the Pistons at their best. Great transition defense. Everyone rotating and challenging the shot.
LA has scored only 16 points in this fourth quarter. Thomas missed the three. They're all over Kareem, and they get the ball back. Mahorn. Under 2 minutes to go, and the Lakers seem to have given it all they had under the circumstances. James Edwards. Rebound Green. But can they get anything against this great Detroit defense? That's the question.
Well, they have plenty of time. You have 1 minute and 44 seconds, and you're only down six. You have the basketball, but you must make it happen now by getting your key guys the basketball.
A story in the fourth period, and Joe Dumars again the leader for the Pistons with 21 points. And there is a sad but human story concerning Louisiana Joe from Natchitoches, Louisiana. He's very close to his family, and a sad story. His father, Joe Sr., has had three heart attacks, and last year, because of diabetes, had both of his legs amputated. Heartbreaking for Joe Dumars out here. But his father said, don't feel sorry for me. Go on with your life. And Joe, before the game, said to me, nothing can ever happen to me that can come close to my dad. I know what severe disappointment is, and he fights through it. And you know, though, that his dad is rooting for him and has to feel so warm and happy for what could be on the verge of Joe and the rest of the Pistons.
Very good. Well said.
Kareem goes in and gets the shot, and it's a four-point game, 100-96. With 1:37 to go. There, the Lakers had a chance to win games two and three of this series, and they've got a chance again.
The Lakers have put in Jeff Lamp now to give them another perimeter shooter.
Nine on the shot clock. Here's Dumars, goes up. But Sally gets the loose ball.
Once again, that great quickness, once again, getting to the loose balls.
And they got a new clock, and they'll get it under a minute now. Dumars from the corner hits. 23 points for Joe Dumars, who has led the parade of the three guards against the Lakers. 1 minute to play. 102-96 Detroit.
They're trying to go to Worthy. Detroit took that option away.
Lamp goes into Kareem. Back to Lamp. Foul on Rick Mahorn. And the camera went down, and Mahorn gingerly collects it. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, 47 seconds left in this game, and his team trailing. Mahorn has fouled out of the game, and Lambeer will replace him. And Kareem Abdul-Jabbar is going out, and there's the hand. One free throw by Lamp, 102-97. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar on the bench, 20 great years. Shot clock shows 10. Lambeer from the corner, bangs one. And the Pistons are up by 7, 104-97. It's their biggest lead of the game, and the Lakers call timeout.
They could do no wrong, Dick. Their ball movement and the guys are knocking down the open shot.
We're back here at the Forum. That's how much time remains. And the Pistons beat the Lakers by 7. Won five titles in the 80s. The champagne is ready in the Detroit dressing room. Detroit lost 60 or more games in the first 2 years of this decade, but they have inched closer each year. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar in the game. He's come back in. Cooper misses a three. Thomas with 20 seconds to go and a foul against Lamp. Spent 8 years at Punxsutawney High School in Pennsylvania and almost got into another profession because he couldn't get it in a college job. That's it for Kareem now. That's it. He's out. Thing he ever wanted was to win a world title. Isaiah Thomas. What a great team that's been, the Lakers. Thomas on the free throw line with 19 seconds to go. Wild chance now. Kareem's name. James Worthy will go out. 40 points for Worthy. Michael Cooper also exits. A.C. Green fires it. Edwards clears. Last year, the Pistons had a 3-2 lead, but couldn't win one of the last two. Now they'll do it. World champs. Joe Dumars is the MVP of the 1989 finals. Scott and Magic Johnson file into the dressing room.
Get to be that unless everybody works hard. And here are their wonderful fans enjoying it in the big arena.
They set a record for the fewest points allowed per game in the playoffs since the NBA adopted the 24-second clock in 1954. They allowed under 93 points a game.
And trophy here in the victorious locker room of the Detroit Pistons when we continue live as we crown a new champion tonight in Inglewood, California. Now the celebration continuing at the Palace in Auburn Hills, Michigan. They had to turn people away tonight. 23,000 showed up. And here inside the Pistons locker room, a victorious team that battled all the way to a seventh game last year before losing. And this year, they have done it four in a row. And now comes time to award the presentation of the trophy, the commissioner of the NBA, David Stern, and the fine owner, Bill Davidson of the Pistons.
Bill, it was a long time in coming, but you've got a very deserving championship team. Congratulations to you, the Pistons, and the city of Detroit.
Yeah, boy. 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 Ye
Bill, your feelings about this.
Look at my...
Let's get Sven Kurempi, Grant. You know, we fought for 15 years to do this. The last three have been real tough in the finals. As you know, we were here last year trying to do it, but it's great, and the harder you work, the better it is.
Bill, I know one of the keys. Isaiah, tell me your thoughts now. I know how hard you've worked for this. Come on over here where everybody can see. This means so much to Isaiah Thomas. Put it into your words for us now.
You know how they always tell you strive to be the best you can be and try to get everything out of yourself that you can as a basketball player, your potential? This is what it means. It means that I got the best out of myself as a small guy in this league. And that's all I can ask for.
All right. Well, the man next to us here who helped us so much, Coach Chuck Daly. Coach, congratulations.
Thank you.
An unbelievable performance by this team.
Really, all on the defensive end, which is basically just hard work. It was unfortunate the Lakers lost a couple people, but that's a fact of life. This club deserved to win it. We won all four series on the road. We deserve to win the championship. Great group of guys.
Couldn't be happy for a group of athletes. And we're going to continue from the victorious locker room of the Detroit Pistons. A very gracious moment here as Magic Johnson has come inside the Pistons locker room. Joe Dumars, the MVP, and your longtime friend, Isaiah Thomas.
Well, I would just tell him that they earned it and deserve it. They played well, outstanding. We just couldn't contain them. They've been playing great defense all along. Isaiah said from the beginning, he told me that they had started off to win the best record, and they did that, and it helped them to have the home court advantage, and they're the champs. And he don't have to talk to me about it to find out what it's like now. Now he knows himself.
Hey, Grandpa has passed the torch.
Daddy, I got me one.
Joe, I've got a moment to get you over here, and just such a solid, gutty performance on your part. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot. We worked hard for it. That was our purpose coming into this season. From day one, we wanted to get here, and here we are.
I know that also you have some thoughts about your father, how difficult it was for you to play through this. Can you share some of those with us?
Yeah, my father's sick. He's back in Louisiana. I know they're all watching back there. They're rooting for us 100%. The ring goes to him.
Thank you very much, Joe. Congratulations. John Sally.
Hey. What's up?
What about, how would you evaluate this Piston team, and what does this championship mean to these players?
This championship means a whole lot to the city of Detroit. It means a ton of lot to John Sally. I came out, I didn't play well enough. I came back, got some block shots. I'm happy for my man Zeke. I miss AD. And everybody in Detroit, we're coming home, having a party. Crazy, crazy party. Thursday and Saturday. What is it? Friday and Saturday. In the morning. Party.
Let the party begin in no time.
Party. Hello to my mother.
And we'll continue as the palace awaits their heroes in just a moment.
Back inside the forum, and John Sally congratulating Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and vice versa. Has this set in yet, Kareem?
Not really. I might have dreams about practice in the morning, but it's definitely over.
What are you going to do in the morning? You find yourself for the first time in a lifetime of not being a basketball player, active anyway.
Well, I'm just going to probably sleep till about 1 o'clock.
When the crowd was cheering, Kareem, and when your teams were high-fiving you, and you went back for that final bow, what was going through your mind? If we can interrupt there.
I just wanted to try to enjoy the moment. Being able to have been as successful as I have for as long as I have has been a truly remarkable experience. And I just wanted to take in the last few moments of it, because we're not going to come back this way again.
Do you realize how remarkable you are and have been? I mean, that's a serious question. Do you really realize it? You look in the mirror and say, hey, I'm Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Well, you know, I've lived with this every day. And when you do that, it's not any big deal to you. It's just what you have to deal with and what you have to do. So I'll probably get a few more thoughts about it. My father sometimes tells me, you know, you're on a plane with Red Grange and people like that. You know, that really is beyond me right now.
Kareem, thank you for all you've given us and given fans across America. Any final word to the fans?
I just want to say thanks a lot. You've been beautiful. Thanks for supporting the game of basketball, and good luck to you. May Allah bless all of you.
Kareem, thank you. It's been one hell of a run. Thank you very much. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, not much to say after that. We'll be back after this.
Coverage of Game 4 of the 1989 NBA Finals has been sponsored by Miller Lite.
sole sponsor of the match of the century, Light-O-Mania. Allstate for home, auto, and life insurance. You're in good hands with Allstate. And by the heartbeat of America, today's Chevrolet.
All right, well, the Lakers are the standard bearers of the sport in the 1980s with five titles, but this is the Detroit Pistons night, Hubie Brown.
They just smothered the Lakers over the last three quarters, Dick. They made it very difficult for them. You're happy for the Detroit guards because they played big in every playoff game.
I enjoyed working with you. You opened up our eyes to a lot of basketball this year. Thank you.
We appreciate that. But how about Kareem? Just a career of nothing but excellence.
All right, and as far as the Detroit Pistons, up until the end of the decade, it was Philly, Boston, and L.A., and finally Detroit breaks that stranglehold, and maybe in the 1990s other clubs will come the way. The one thing we can say is that tonight, the state of Michigan is the basketball capital of the world with the Wolverines, NCAA champions of the University of Michigan, and the world champions, the Detroit Pistons of the NBA. So, well, once again, the NBA playoffs have given us high drama in May and June. And as we crown the Pistons with their first championship in franchise history, we'd like to thank all the teams and players of the National Basketball Association for all the great moments. The 1989 finals are history. Hail the new champions, the Detroit Pistons.